Originally, Philip Greenman taught it like this. Hold on the back of your head here.
Right.
To come in
and
contact, you really aren't contacting the diaphragm, right? I mean, you know, you're just hopefully influencing it. But when you use this motion here.
For sure.
Now push forward right here, just gently, two,
I use this one a
three,
whole lot with my patterning and athletes,
four,
baseball players,
five, and relax because of that crossing pattern we talked about. Remember on bat, how they're going across in that right motor dominant pattern?
Right.
Well, here's one of the things that really helps it. Get into the transabdominal fascia. She likes this, doesn't she?
Yeah.
Okay, push here against me, two, three, four, five, and we just kind of stretch and open that whole thing up. Show that. I like that again. I haven't seen that before.
The way I was coming in the diaphragm?
Yeah.
Now you could do it, you know, obviously a couple different ways. I did behind the back just to add a little more stretch to it. So I'm in here this way, and now I'm in this way coming underneath the diaphragm. Now she could do some activation for me by reaching over her head. A lot of times what I want to do, though, is actually start the patterning. Yeah.
Move it.
Let's
move
do
away.
Some internal-external rotation with that arm. So she internally
the
rotates
whole arm,
the elbow.
The entire arm.
And then external. And when she does that into internal, I take the slack out. And she goes into
That's
external,
exactly
it winds
right.
it up.
Mm-hmm.
She goes into internal, and I take out the slack.
And,
or she could also take that deep breath if she'd like. It pushes that diaphragm down. And then as she exhales, she can internally rotate that arm.
Uh-huh.
Then she can inhale and externally rotate that arm. So remember, on inhalation, what does the body do? It goes into external rotation.
So see what he's doing here? So when it's internal, that's when he's pumping it. He's helping that thing
and so now
recoil.
All right.